one question that
yeah, anything pertain to this
was kind of nice about this, where talk about adding EQ plugins where you're boosting or adding a compressor plugin. People, yep. do you change the output gain? And the answer, yeah, I think, is mostly yes, that you want, if you're putting some of the compressor plugins, I know you're not a big compressor guy in your mix, but a lot of the compressor plugins will actually add a little bit of gain.
It's annoying.
Which is annoying as fuck.
No, it's why I don't like compressor plugins.
You can change the defaults on a lot of these. I've done it with some of them that I use, but really, if you're going to add an EQ or add a compressor, as that applies to gain staging and signal flow, what you should do is you should have a signal that's about here. You add a compressor, and then the resulting signal is about the same level, just sounds a little compressed. That's the way to really adjust it. You're going to have to you add your compressor and then adjust the output gain and AB, so it's pretty similar. So you can actually hear what the compressor is doing and not be fooled by it.
Like it.
Yeah, not be fooled by it raising the volume in some respect. And then also, if it raises the volume, you're then changing the relationship across all of the multitrack, where all of a sudden one of your tracks is louder and then you're pulling down you want things to come in and out at a very similar volume.
Yeah. So especially when you're in the mix process, producers and artists and managers and the teams have dialed in vibe, you know, for weeks, a month, months, years, for so long. And you throw a compressor on a guitar track and it makes it 3 dB louder, but you're like, oh shit, that guitar sounds sick. Meanwhile, the background vocals now are covered by the strumming acoustic guitar that they were like, yo, that was an afterthought for rhythm. Like, we barely even wanted that there, but you're like, damn, that's so good. Like, yeah, that's not a Jason Mraz track though. This is something else. Like, we don't need it to be up like that. You always have to be A-B-ing what you're adding, because, well, what is it doing to the sound? And then what is it doing to the song, to the record? Just because the guitar sounds tight now doesn't mean the guitar was supposed to sound that good to begin with, right? So that's why you're adding this this plugin. Every plugin should be determined and deemed better or worse, I guess, for lack of better words. I kind of hate those words, but they do serve a purpose for educational things.
Yeah, when you're adding things into your chain, into your signal flow, something starting here, adding something in the middle, you don't want to then change the volume. The volume relationship should stay the same.